There is something special about the way they play baseball in St. Paul.
The University of St. Thomas baseball team knocked on the door of a national championship for 2 years, but no one answered, so the Tommies kicked it in.
The Tommies took the whole enchilada tonight, their first ever national championship in baseball.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Fox City Stadium for the 2001 NCAA Division III Baseball Championship game.
After winning their first game today, Marietta earns the right to play the Tommies tonight for the NCAA D3 title, College World Series at Appleton, Wisconsin.
Before we go out in the field, we always come up together defensively. And I could just kind of sense, you know, maybe it wasn't a little tension, but I made sure I said, okay, everybody, smile. So we just stood there and smiled for about half a second when we took the field. And that seemed to loosen us up a little bit.
This did not look like a banner year for the Tommies, finishing third in the MIAC. But they led the nation in hitting. And their pitching staff came through at a perfect time.
We've always had great pitching the years I've been here, and we've had to scratch out a few runs here and there. And this year, we had everybody through the lineup, and everybody got hot at the right time, which was big.
Well, there's a lot of luck involved.
Luke say they're bouncing to second, but it's a boot, and that brings the run home.
Things just kind of bounced our way a little bit today. Those hits fell in and made the plays when we had to.
We always try to make a point out of it. Whatever happens at the plate, you leave it there. You go out and play good defense because you can control that.
On the field, off the field, you know, we're all friends. There's no egos on this team that get in the way. There's no, you know, groups, cliques within the team. We just get along, you know, we hang out off the field, and then it's just easy to come here and play with your friends.
Brad Bonine of St. Thomas was able to take a trip the easy way around the bases here. He smashed a two-run homer to put St. Thomas up 7-3 in the sixth inning.
Yeah, it feels really good, I guess, to finally win one. I thought it would never happen, but just really happy for all the guys on the team.
The four-run lead was enough cushion for the Tommy starter, Brian Winery. Winery went the distance and struck out six.
Early in the game, I kind of took it easy. When we had two outs, I relaxed a little bit, and I needed to, you know, stay focused and get that third out because they had a lot of two-out rallies.
As the game went on today, I kept telling him, hey, I might pull you. Are you okay? Or what do you feel like? And just threatening him a little bit so he'd stay focused the next inning. He didn't know that. He said, Coach, leave me. I was just yanking you. I hope you understand that.
He didn't get a strikeout to finish things off, but he did get a little fly ball to center field to wrap up the title. The celebration was on as St. Thomas wins the title 8-4.
In every heart, there is a drum that beats steady and strong. It does not know defeat. I feel it bound and know the sound of truth.
This is unbelievable. It's the best feeling in the world. Last year we made it so close and lost a couple in the championship. Broke our hearts. This year we finally pulled it out. Feels great.
The proudest we could be. I cannot.
I mean, for some of us, this has been a long time waiting. And, you know, being national runner-up 2 years in a row, you can't describe the feelings. You know, all of us, even on the bus ride home, it was, you know, we just look at each other and just smile.
Hey, hell of a game, baby. That was one gutsy performance. Not a kid.
That's what we needed, baby. You did it.
The best thing about the whole thing was the bus ride back home. The kids played their rap music and their country music and all the stuff I just hate. Anyway, when we got all the way back to St. Paul here, now we hit Crete and they put the We Are the Champions back on and sang that thing. That bus was just vibrating.
Give me some love, huh?
We get good kids here. They have it in the right perspective. You know, they want it. They want to get a good career. They want to get a good job. And they also want to play baseball, you know. And our kids love to play. And we're competitive. And we might not win them all, but you know what? We're going to compete with you. And we proved it this weekend. It was good for the MIC and good for St. Paul and good for Minnesota that we go to the greatest tournament they have in Division III, you know, 350 teams or whatever, and we came out on top. We competed with the best.